Imagine you're the only chef in a busy kitchen. Someone orders soup and toast. What do? You put a pot of water and ingredients on the stove, and then just stand there, staring at the pot, waiting. When it's finally done, you pop the bread into the toaster. And guess what? Yep, you just stand there again, staring at the toaster until it pops. Congrats, you've just experienced synchronous cooking. The chef here is like a thread, and this poor thread is stuck, can't move, can't multitask, just wasting time staring at the soup. Obviously, that's not efficient. In C#, it's the same story. A thread might be waiting for a database query, or a file download, or some API call. While it's waiting, it can't do anything else. That's where our hero comes in, async and await. First, let's understand the thread pool. In ASP.NET Core Web App, a server has a limited thread pool. Imagine you only have 100 chefs. Now 100 users come in, each ordering something that takes 2 seconds to query the database. All 100 chefs are busy just standing and staring at the database. The 101st user? Sorry, buddy. You'll have to wait outside. But with async, a chef starts the database query and then immediately says, "Cool, while that's cooking, I'll help someone else." The moment the database is ready, any free chef can pick it up and finish the job. This is why async lets a small number of threads handle thousands of requests. Nice, right? So let's go back to our soup and toast. We can set the boiling soup and toasting bread task as asynchronous task. Then we add the await keyword. It's like saying, these tasks will take a while. Go do other stuff and come back when it's done. Here, we can use Task.WhenAll to await them both. Task.WhenAll creates a new task that only completes when all the tasks inside it are finished. After the await, we can safely access the results to serve the meal. Talking about .result, now let's see a mistake about it. When using .result or .wait, it's basically saying, I don't care if it's async task. Just stand there and wait until it's finished. In older ASP.NET, this can lead to a classic problem, deadlock. Here's how a deadlock happens. In this example, this action method is not an async method, but it's calling an async method and use .result to block the thread and make it become synchronous. Inside the async method, it tries to free the thread, but the thread is being blocked. Yup, deadlock. It's like the chef are trying to help others, but just standing there, not moving. And in modern ASP.NET Core, it may not deadlock, but you're still blocking a precious thread, like hogging a chef who could have been helping someone else. This will cause thread pool starvation. So, it's not recommended to use .result while the task hasn't completed. You can only use after you awaited the task. Okay, what if you don't actually care about the result? Like, I just want to log a user activity. Then, do we still need to await that? This is called fire and forget. Sounds cool, but it's risky. First, are you sure you don't need to show the result to the front end? If you don't want to show it for now, is it possible you want to show it in the future? Or did you handle the exception nicely? With async await, when there's an exception, the exception is rethrown at the await line, allowing you to catch it in a standard try-catch block. But if you don't await and you didn't handle exception when the async task failed, an unhandled exception might crash the entire application process. So, if you truly want to fire and forget, you need a proper handling mechanism, but the simplest and safe rule is always await the async task. Now, here's another common confusion. Async means multi-threading, right? No, it's not multi-threading. Multi-threading is about having multiple workers doing jobs at the same time, like hiring more chefs for your kitchen. This is great for CPU-intensive work like complex video rendering where you need more raw processing power. But async is about a single worker being very efficient at managing waiting time. It's perfect for I/O tasks like waiting for a database, an API call, or a file process. Okay, now let's look at example of using async for a list. In this example, when we call an async method inside a for each loop, yes, async still works, although it processes the items one at a time. You might ask, how to process them all concurrently, like our earlier task.WhenAll? We can do it like this. Start all the download tasks at once. Use await task.WhenAll to wait for all of them to complete, way faster. So here's the takeaway. Sync is like you're blocking to stare at soup until it boils. Async is non-blocking. You can boil soup, toast, and help other customers while you wait. We can also understand from a real-life example, sync and async communication. Synchronous communication is like a face-to-face or online meeting discussion, where you ask about something and you are blocked in that call to wait for the reply. Async communication is like text messaging where you send a message to your colleague and doing other works while waiting for a reply. So, async and await isn't scary. It's your superpower for building high-performance applications by non-blocking the thread and managing the waiting time efficiently. All right, if this helped you clear things up, smash that like button, share with your coding friends, and subscribe for more content. Thanks for watching and happy coding!